see the story, Anbu and the fish. Now we enter the story.
The main character of this story, Anbu and Madan. Both of them are friends. Their hobby is fishing. Anbu was very talented in catching fish. They always went to catch fish, so they used dhoti as a net to catch fish. Anbu also made fishing rods using sticks and thorns at home. Rods means a thin straight piece of wood. They went to the pond and catch the fish. Then they are sharing the fish equally. They never went deep into the pond. They were so while searching the earthworms. For what purpose? The earthworms is the food of fish. One Sunday they went to catch fish. On that time Anbu was not happy because they had only 3 fish. So they decided to grow the fish at home. Then he took a jar and filled it with water and let the 3 fish into it. The fishes swam in different directions. He thought fishes were hungry, so he put earthworms into the jar. But the fishes did not eat. Anyway, he saw their eyes and could feel their fear. Next day morning, he woke up and saw only 2 fish in the jar. What happened to the 1 fish? Then he searched for the fish. He saw that fish on the floor. His father consoled him. Then his father bought a 1 fish tank. Then he changed the fish to the new tank. Next day, 1 more fish was dead. So Anbu was startled cry. This is the climax of this story. Then his father told these fish live in the pond and river. So nature is their home. So you take a fish and leave it in the pond. Then he went to the pond and left the fish. After his father's advice, both of them changed their hobby. How? Next, Anbu and Madan bought a packet of puffed rice and fed the fish. Instead of fishing, feeding fish was their new hobby. Okay, students, now read the story. Anbu and the fish. Anbu was talented in catching fish. He always went to catch fish with Madan. They usually used dhoti as a net to catch the fish. Anbu also made fishing rods using sticks and thorns at home. Then they shared the fish equally. Unlike their friends, Anbu and Madan were always careful while fishing. They never went deep into the pond or river. Every Sunday, they would go in search of earthworms to use them as bait. They enjoyed searching for earthworms. Once the bait was ready, they would go fishing. On Sunday, Anbu was not happy. They were able to catch only 3 fish. The fish very small to cook, so they decided to grow the fish at home. Anbu filled the jar with water and let the 3 fish into it. The fish exited and swam in different directions. Anbu thought the fish was hungry and dropped earthworms into the jar. But to his surprise, the fish did not eat. He saw their eyes could feel their fear. Next morning, he went straight to the fish jar from his bed. He saw only 2 fish in the jar. He searched for the fish everywhere. Then he saw one fish on the floor. Anbu was very sad, and his father consoled him. In the evening, his father got a new fish tank. Anbu changed the fish to the new tank. The next day, Anbu rushed back from school to the tank. He saw that one more fish was dead and floating on the top. He started crying. His father said, "These fish live in the river and lake. Nature is their home. It is best to let them be free." He saw the lost fish swimming alone, and he felt bad. He took the fish to the same pond and set it free. From then on, Anbu and Madan bought a packet of buffed rice and fed the fish. Feeding fish was their new hobby. Friends, today's mannerism: no creature should be harmed. Okay, thank you, students.